Hello, my name is Arnaud Delorme and I'm the main software architect of the EEGLAB software. This is part 5 about EEG preprocessing in EEGLAB, and this part is about examining your data and looking at artifacts. So we are now here at this step. We just finished filtering, so examining raw data. And there's two ways to look at raw data in EEGLAB. There's two menus. There's this menu, scroll data, and there is this other menu, tools, reject data by eye. And both of the two menus actually have the same functions. You can do the same thing with both menus. And when you click on these menus, then you can see your data. So we're going to look a little bit at the screen. So first, you have settings. This is where you set the times, the number of channels you want to see, whether you want to display events or not. You have this edit box here where you can see what's this, where is the beginning of the data pointing to. So here that's time zero is at the beginning. It can also be when you're visualizing data epochs. This will be the first epoch. What is the first epoch that's being seen? These buttons are for scrolling back and forth. This is the button for scaling, so you can scale the EEG up and down, and here is the scale shown here. And then you have event markers. So in this case, I have two types of event. I have square and RT, which means reaction time. So square is the stimulus and RT is the reaction time. And then you can see here, for instance, we can see some alpha wave very clearly in this subject. And now what kind of artifact should you look for? First, why look for artifacts? Well, the amplitude of artifacts, such as eye movements, is often larger than the amplitude of brain data, which potentially decrease signal noise ratio, bias data analysis, and potentially results when you process your data. For instance, this is EEG data, so this is background EEG data, and these are blinks. So you can see the amplitude of the blink is an order of magnitude higher than the underlying brain data. There's many types of artifacts. Here I'm just representing a couple. For instance, you can have here high frequency artifact. This can be muscle, especially over temporal electrodes. You can have low frequency, for instance, eye movements, or even when the eyes close, you can have eye rollings. You can have also discontinuity in the signal, as we can see here, one electrode jumps. It's just an artifact of the amplifier. You can have high noise, that's not muscle, it's just electrical noise. And you can also have linear drift in your data. So the other thing you might want to do is to look for bad channels. So here, for instance, we can see this channel is probably a bad channel. So it is very important to look at the at your data. That's one of the key step. There is no universal method for cleaning EEG data. So you'll have to look at your data and familiarize to what kind of artifact some method remove and what are the true artifacts you would want to remove. So here I'll do a simple live demo. Again, using the same continuous dataset in the sample data folder. So file, load dataset in the sample data folder of EEGLAB. That's the one. I'm going to use this menu, plot channel scroll data. And so we can move forward. We can change the scale here, for instance. So here we see nice alpha rhythm. There's not much artifact. There's one artifact here, a strong discontinuity in this signal. But it's been here another one, but it's been clean overall and made available to to people. In the next part, we'll talk about removing bad channels.